know that disinformation is very toxic to the public discourse. It's different from misinformation in the sense that it's deliberately aimed at confusing, obfuscating the truth, and also propagating false information in order to deceive. What are the best tactics to try to counter this? Well, the bigger question is the genie out of the bottle? In other words, is it potentially too late? The optimistic view is that it's not, is that there is a multi-pronged potential response to this. One could be from the supply side of disinformation, which means that the people who are and the institutions and even the state actors who are behind disinformation could be either fined or sanctioned if they do not take steps to limit the amount of fake news or disinformation that is propagated around the world. The other is from the demand side, so it means potentially educating younger people, especially, that everything they see online and on social media is not necessarily truthful. It aims potentially at educating some programs, young people, in fact checking. How do you know that what you see online or what you see on your Facebook feed is true or not? This is why journalism is an actual craft. It's a profession, because we have been trained as journalists to weed out what is fake from what is true. Why not take some of that education that we learn and practice every day and, for instance, teach it in schools in the same way you teach in schools, say, history, geography, or math? So you can approach the problem from two sides. The one big conclusion is there is not one answer. There is not one solution. It's many solutions, and it's continuing to raise awareness that disinformation and fake news is toxic and poisonous to our democracies and to our public conversations.